if I said this in a lonely town, and what I wouldn't give to have a friend around.
We could trade in all our silver bullets and buy a patch of dust. This town might just be big enough. For all of us.
Brian, I invited a large number of girls over here for an orgy tonight, but I have to say the responses thus far haven't been exactly what I'd hoped for.
Stacy had a headache, Jenny was in jail. Brenda had to work late, Kate was getting Jenny's bail. Angela got scurvy, Ashley caught a cold. Sally's dad exploded, that's what I was told. Michelle had to play checkers, Dan was baking pies. Wendy's dad exploded too, that might have been a lie. Pam had frisbee lessons, Stella had ballet. Now I'm by myself, but I can have one anyway. So dim, dim the lights,
lights.
Remove my tights, yeah.
Nobody showed, but I'm gonna have some fun.
Let's get this party started, it's an orgy for one.
Shane was way too shy. Steve was not invited because he was a guy.
Claire was parasailing. Brooke said she was in space. But it doesn't matter cause I'm rounding second base. All through
nights,
nights. My grass is tight. Oh!
Beating so hard you'd think I was a drum.
Alone and I'm talking on my thumbs. It's not just masturbation, it's an art.
Hey guys, good morning. That's Sans from Undertale. Good morning, everyone. Hope you're all doing well. How's it going, Vastus? Big Bad Knight? Mushroom Madam? Good to see you all. Big Bad, got to go soon, but I'm getting a raise today from 17 to 18 an hour. Congratulations! That's awesome. Really happy to hear that. More than well deserved, I'm sure. How's everyone doing? I'll be honest, I'm pretty tired today. Roommate decided to play a movie as loud as he could in the middle of the night, so I'm a little bit tired. I'm a little bit cranky. But that's okay. We're gonna have fun anyway. But yeah, I've got a new program today. I'm just doing a demo for it. I bet Mush. So this program's called Rebelle, R-E-B-E-L-L-E. I tried it a little bit last night and it seemed pretty fun. If you're looking for a program to do like actual painting in, it seems like a good one. I don't know if I want to buy it yet, so I wanted to mess around with it some more, do some drawing, do some painting, and yeah. With that being said, let's get started. Well, my name is Jesse J. Jones, and this is my stream. I'm Jesse J. Jones, and that is my name. I'm gonna paint and doodle and try to draw some things. I'm gonna paint over the canvas and probably mess it up a lot. Alright. Also, I don't know, but hopefully the alert should be fixed. Hopefully the goddamn fucking alert should be fixed today. Hey Gums, how's it going? Yeah, see, they're not doing the bring. I think it's fixed. I think we fixed it, possibly. So, no real plan today. Let's draw something cute. First let's make a wash. Let's grab like a big watery kind of brush. So there's a ton of brushes to mess with here. Let's try mop. Mop looks pretty good. Let's do that. I'm feeling like a blue today. Feels pretty nice. And what you can do is you can also add more water to your brush. You know, it makes it a bit darker and sometimes it'll actually like drip on the canvas and stuff. It's pretty neat. Let's add a bit more like cyan to it, just a little bit. So this is usually, I'm gonna follow the same process I do for actual painting. So you can see if we zoom in, there's actual, like, canvas texture on here. So any tool that you use, like if we grabbed a pastel brush here and, like, draw over it, it draws over the top of the canvas, depending what kind of a canvas you have. It's pretty neat. It's pretty cool. That's awesome, Big Bad. Really glad to hear that. The only thing, the only reason I'm thinking of not getting the software is just because my computer can't run it that well. And you know, if your brush is laggy, it makes it kind of it makes it hard to draw. It's like you can't really be creative when you're waiting for your brush to catch up, you know? There's a blow dryer. You can dry out your painting if you need to, which we probably need to do. Oh. Nope, I don't like that. I don't know what that did. That's kind of cool, though. Did something. Let's grab a marker. Let's get a dried out marker. Add a new layer. Let's pick a color set that we like. There's one called crayons. Seems like a good one. Do like a light blue. Can you even see that? Maybe increase the brush size. You're getting a promotion. You guys got any plans today? Anything going on? It's Tuesday after all. You know what they say, Tuesday's the most exciting day. Exactly 8 hours since I've drawn bunny boobs, so we're gonna draw bunny boobs. Is this an instrumental version of the finished polka? I've never heard this before. This is awesome. Tearing the room apart and cleaning? That sounds good. I always feel rejuvenated after doing cleaning. Alright, so there's our base sketch. Let's grab some oil paint. Since I usually don't do a lot of oil paint stuff, let's try messing with that. Get like a base coat. Yellowish base coat. I don't like that the new layer button is on the bottom. I really like the way, Clip Studio does it. Hey, Draco, how's it going? Another awesome streamer if you guys don't follow Draco Fox. Super talented, super nice. Can I just do slash S? There you go. I could stream. I'm a good streamer. There we go. Yeah, this stream is perfect for lurking in, because I'm just going to be messing around with this program, and I don't really know what I'm doing, so it's going to be a lot of, like, just experimenting, trying things out. I was trying gouache paints in this program before, and really liking it. But it's kind of cool. You can see, like, texture on your stuff. It's kind of neat. I've only done oil paints in school. I've never done oil paints outside of school at all. Have a good lurk, Mush. Oh, you're not lurking. Well, that's what the lurk alert is for. Let's see. What do these other ones do? Filbert? I like... You don't really get this in Clip Studio where the brush, like, follows the angle that you're going at. I haven't found a brush in Clip Studio that does that. I know Krita has some tools that do stuff like that, which is kind of neat. There's an artist I really like that uses Krita and does really cool painting stuff with it. It's probably mostly why I wanted to try out this program, just because I really admire their work a lot, and they have like a very traditional painterly kind of workflow. There's a textured knife. Let's see what that looks like. That's kind of cool. Yeah, like I said, I'm gonna be experimenting with all these. There's a ton of brushes in here to mess around with. There's also blending tools in here. Like a texture one, so you can blend that way. Seems to work pretty well. Yeah, I really like this program. It's just, I wish it wasn't so laggy on my computer. And I'd absolutely get it. But, you know. It has to be something that I like using better than Clip Studio Paint. Like, Clip Studio Paint I like using so much, and I've already got it, like, configured in a way that I'm really happy with it, you know? And it runs super fast. Like, I can make a giant canvas on Clip Studio Paint and it runs no problem. This one, it really chugs. If you make a huge canvas, it really doesn't like it. There's also acrylics in here. There's some grunge textures. Ooh. I mean, I wouldn't usually use this, but it's kind of neat. You can see the texture of the paint. Actually, I could see this being useful if you wanted to do, like, specifically paint-looking commissions, you know? I usually don't like this kind of look. But it's pretty neat. It's pretty cool. Wow. Oh, it looks like paint. Oh. Yeah, I really don't like that. But it's cool to see. Undo all that fucking shit. There's a rake. That's pretty cool. Also, it feels really good with the pressure sensitivity. There's fan brush, so you could do, like, your stupid trees and shit. Supposedly, there's a way to, like, rotate the brush, but I haven't figured out a way to do it. It's just always sideways. I guess you have to hold your pen that way. Oh, I think that's how it works. So it detects the tilt of your pen. But it's kind of awkward with the fan brush. It feels like it's 90 degrees off from what it should be. Let's go back to watercolors. See, there's gouache ones. There's kind of a bristly one, kind of a dry brush. It's kind of nice. Yeah, you might want to check out this program, Mush, if you like traditional stuff. It's very intuitive. And they're having a sale right now, which I think is going to end pretty soon. It's, like, super discounted. You can get it for, like, 35 bucks right now. I'll type it in chat. It's called Rebel or Rebel? They're on version 7 right now. Gouache wash. Love a good gouache wash. That feels nice. The This song, whenever it plays in my car, I always get scared of that explosion sound. It always scares me and it sucks. Add a bit of fading to the bottom here. I wouldn't really be able to erase paint like this, but it's digital, so it's fine. Suppose if you want to be a real stickler with it, you just wouldn't use the tools that don't make sense. Like, you probably wouldn't be able to draw on top of this with a marker very easily. But in this program, it's fine. Yeah, see it? It lagged a little bit there when I was just trying to use spacebar to pan around. There's a really cool feature called NanoPixel. It uses like AI to upscale your artwork. I'm not sure how it works, but it like turns all of your pixels into fractals. So you can actually export your painting like 16 times larger than how you paint it. It's very cool. Let's see, let's do some shadows. Let's find a good brush for doing shadows. Gouache Filbert? I usually don't like filbert brushes. Usually more of a fan of flat brushes. I definitely have a good time doing this kind of painting though. It is really nice. When it's not lagging, it feels super nice. Very intuitive. And the nice thing about digital is we can give her her pizza bikini. We can do the pizza bikini at this very moment. Hey, Melted Jedi, how's it going? We're messing with a new painting program today. One that I don't have too much experience with, but just messing around with it. Been pretty fun. Have you can't find it within yourself to stand up, number two. You don't deserve to wear that uniform.
This is becoming a speech.
You're the captain, sir. You're entitled.
Not entitled to ramble on about something everyone knows.
Captain John Picard of USS Enterprise. Let's turn up the yellow a little bit.
Just kept talking in one long, incredibly unbroken sentence.
So fun. I do really like this program. So most of the reason I'm doing this today is just to see if I actually want to buy it. I'm just on the free trial, which I would recommend if you wanted to test it out. Use the free trial first. Telling your father-in-law about my channel last night? That's funny. How did that come up? Rush fan line. What does this do? Oh, it's kind of like a dry brush. It could be kind of good for some ambient occlusion, maybe. Captain Jean-Luc Picard of USS Enterprise.
have to call again. I'm just leaving.
So here's what I would do. So I would paint in my solid colors, just kind of like cell shading, if you're familiar with cell shading. And then take your blending tool and just blend the edges where any soft spots are. Just kind of soften those out a little bit. Also, the fact that it's wet kind of helps it blend too. Hey, Whirl! You'd probably like this program. You were talking about programs that can do like traditional medium, like traditional painting. This one feels very good, and it's also on sale, which is the reason I'm messing with it, because I wanted to see if it was something I like. But you can see how the paint's kind of like bleeding and stuff. And you can also see like the texture of the paper kind of coming through.
I am the cutest of all. You will respond to my question.
Oh, he's a cartoonist. That's awesome.
You are bored. I am the cutest of all. You will assist us.
Yeah, I get like error messages like this. I think my tablet can't run it very well, but if you have a decent computer.
I am the cutest of all.
Thank you, Mush. Yeah, it's called Rebel. Rebel? Rebel? It's very fun. I'm liking it a lot. Let's show off something really cool. Let's grab a big fat water color brush and then fill it full of water. Let's grab a color like green or something. And if you just paint like is it dripping? I know you can add water. There is a way to add water. So if I grab water here and add a bunch of water down here, maybe? Like that. And then turn off show wet. It might be a bit slow on my computer, but you can kind of see it bleeding and stuff. I was doing it earlier. I was able to make it, like, be really drippy. I wonder how I did that. I guess you could kind of see it. See how it's, like, bleeding through the paper and stuff. This is version 6, also. Version 7, it seems like. They added a bunch of new features for things to feel more real. Oh, look, it is dripping, but it's... Oh, I think this tilt is what's causing it to drip that direction. I think if I tilt it down... Oh, there it goes. There. Okay, so that's what this tilt wheel does. It tilts where gravity is, I guess. But yeah, you can see, like... Wherever it's wet, it's kind of bleeding through, and then it's also, like, dripping down. It was pretty neat. It was pretty cool. You can also take a hair dryer, and, like, dry it out by just blowing over it, and that should stop it from being as wet. There's also a button to, like, stop all of that dripping all at once. I haven't found that yet, but it's somewhere. Oh my god, I've made such a mess. Yeah, I would like to use it for making backgrounds. Like if you make a... Like kids' books backgrounds or something, it would be pretty cool. I'm gonna undo this maybe? There we go. Let's turn the tilt back. How do you dry? Oh, this is dry. I see. So if you want to dry things out, you just use the dry. And anywhere where it has this mode where it's called show wet, anywhere where it's like light blue is where the paint is still wet. So you can just dry off where you don't want things to drip, just like that. Go back to painting. That's kind of like how I was using my heat gun when I was painting IRL. Hey, Katsudan, good to see you. Blood effects, yeah, that would be very cool. Let's try painting the face here. That needs more red, I think. Yeah, just the default brushes. There's so many good ones to mess around with. Like, I feel like you wouldn't have to download any brushes, really. All the default ones it comes with are plenty good. Also, like I was saying, it's really good at detecting tilt, so you have to kind of pretend that you are holding a paintbrush while doing it. Because it will take into account how you are holding your brush. It's pretty cool. So there's flat, there's round. What is this paper one? Oh, it's kind of a neat texture. I'm liking that. Yeah, I feel if once you get really familiar with the tools in this program, you could do some really neat stuff. I am liking it more. The more I'm using it, the more I'm liking this program. I don't know if I need the pro version. Probably just the regular version would be enough. And also maybe the regular version would take away features I wouldn't use, so it like declutters it a little bit. I'd have to look again what the difference between the pro version and the regular version was. This is fun though, I really like it. Maybe we should mess with the oil paints. We haven't really done a lot of oil painting. You know what we should do? What would be fun is to follow a Bob Ross video. Should we try that? Should we follow a Bob Ross video? It's so weird. I'm not used to using tilt while painting. You can kind of see how it, like, blends in with the color underneath it. Oh, that's really neat. That's super cool. Yeah, Yeah, let's do it. Let's do a Bob Ross one. Don't save changes. Oh, and you can record time lapse. That's cool. Alright, let's find a Bob Ross episode. Are they just on YouTube? I'm gonna change what I'm doing. So we're not doing character design anymore. Following Bob Ross video. Transform, center to horizontal. Alright, let's look for Bob Ross full episode. There's 400 videos. Let's find a nice one. There's one called Mountain Lake that looks like quintessential Bob Ross. Let's do this one. Alright. I am gonna change music as well, because this might be a little bit distracting. Let's find something that doesn't have lyrics. Playlist. Copyright free happy music. Let's do this one. I always like this mix here. This one. We'll put it kind of low, just so it's in the background. Okay, pop out Bob. Okay, YouTube. Capture Bob Ross. Picture in picture. Oh, I gotta fix the cropping, I think. There he is. There's the man. There we go. Good old Bob. Where should we put him? Let's put him. Over here? Down here? Yeah, down there. That feels pretty good. Alright, Bob. Show us the way.
Welcome back. I'm certainly glad you could join me today. You ready to do a fantastic little painting with me? Super. Tell you what, let's have them run all the colors across the screen.
Music's distracting. I'm going to pause it.
And while they're doing that, let me tell you what I've done. I've got my old standard 18 by 24 inch canvas up here. I've covered it with a thin, even coat of the liquid white, and it's all ready to go.
Yep, mine's ready to go.
Drag out your paints or pull up your easy chair. Either one.
And I'm in my easy chair. Together.
Let's start out today with some Prussian blue. Good,
Prussian blue.
Strong, dark blue. Just a little bit of it. Let me say that again. A little bit of it, because it is very strong. On the 2-inch brush, let's go right up here, and let's just drop in a happy little sky. Let's just do a fun painting today. Start at the very top of the canvas, working all the way across, making little X's, little crisscross strokes. Little crisscross strokes. There we go. And by working across like that, and then begin working downward, your paint is mixing with the liquid white that's already on the canvas.
This is so fun.
Your color will get lighter and lighter toward the horizon. And that's exactly what we're looking for today.
Mine's not getting lighter.
Let the paint work, the canvas work. Shoot.
Because it's not real.
Just let it go. There we go.
It's not real.
Very lightly go across the whole sky. Just take out the brush strokes and bring everything together. And that quick, we got a quick little sky. Very simple and easy. Now then, add a little more of that color into the brush. Maybe we'll have a little water down here. Shoot, I love water. So, maybe the water lives in our world. Oh, I'm not sure where it's going to be. So let's just throw some blue in. Wherever we want water, we'll have it there. If we don't want water, we'll paint right over it. We're not committed at this point. We can do anything that we want to do here. Any old thing.
Okay. I want to get a brush like his. Hold on.
Now, very lightly, we'll go across.
Hold on, Bob. What kind of a brush is he using? Just flat oily? I think... Can you add, like, less paint to it? A little bit less paint? Knife dry, maybe? It's not a knife. He's not using a knife, really. Fat round, rough wet? Paper? No. Hairy? Hairy brush? There we go. That's a little bit closer to what he's using. Play.
It's an entire canvas. Three hairs and some air. There. Now then, let's wash our old brush. We'll just scrub him off in some odorless thinner. Give him a shake. And just beat the devil out of it. Sometimes those brushes get away and they go zoom.
Rip devil.
Inside the room. That's when you find out who your friends are. Take a little of the titanium white. Just pull it in one direction through the brush there. Get a lot of color on the brush. Shoot, let's make some big old fluffy clouds that live up here in the sky.
Some titanium white?
Tiny little circles. Tiniest little circles. There we go. And we're looking for a basic shape here. Don't just throw this on at random and hope that a cloud will appear. Sort of.
This is so fun.
As you want to do. There we go. Just basic cloud.
I've never
shapes.
Actually painted along with the Bob Ross video before.
Look here. If you just stay here and keep working and working and working, all you end up with is a big cotton ball. Now I got to get rid of that. See, but if you do one of those, you do a cloudectomy, and you're in business.
Man, that's cool.
That's all it takes.
He makes it look so easy. Moving.
Let them dance in there. Just let them play. Clouds are one of the freest things in nature. We'll give him a hand right here.
I love you!
There we are. Other side.
Thank you. I love you too.
And just some very basic little
shapes. I fixed my alerts. They're not
whatever
being
want.
Stupid anymore.
There. When we were kids, we used to look at clouds and see all kind of things. And same thing happens in your paintings.
Do kids even still clouds look at clouds anymore?
A lot of
they're so busy looking on their phones.
Okay, now we're just going to use the top corner of the 2-inch brush. Gently, gently blend those clouds. Gently blend them. Just here and there. Don't overwork them. Don't overwork them. Now, we'll lift them. Give them a little fluff.
Luffing them. Luffing over here, Bob.
Very lightly. Two hairs and some air. Just give them a little blend.
Two hairs and some air.
So give you
Rip
some
devil.
Nice practice with clouds. They're a lot of fun to do. And they're very, very easy.
That is
very
fun.
Easy. I beat the brush just to knock off excess paint so I don't have to clean it. Now we can lift these up. Make some big old floaters out of them. There we go.
Now maybe my clouds aren't quite as happy as Bob's, but they're still looking okay.
Maybe there's another little cloud that lives in the front here. When you can do these clouds and make just layer after layer of them, but do the one that's farthest away first and work forward, always working forward.
Makes sense.
There we go. Maybe it comes right on over here. We don't know.
So maybe. Relaxing. This is so nice.
Today I'd like to do let's do a big mountain. I get a lot of requests from
clouds are big now.
That don't have snow all over them. Big dark mountains.
Yeah, I've heard about that cloud conspiracy. And if, you know, the more you look into it, the more the more interesting it becomes. That's all I'll say about it.
So let's do that. All right.
Big government wants you to believe in clouds.
And we'll put a little Van Dyke brown into it.
Van Dyke brown.
A lot of color. Pull the paint out flat.
Really, so like pressure. This color?
Pull straight down. Cut across.
And he's using a knife.
Let's go up here. Now you have to make a big decision real quick.
Big decision.
Where's your mountain going to live? Maybe in our world.
Oh, big decision time.
Comes right down here, wherever you want it. Shoot, just drop it in. Really push that paint in there.
His is a bit darker. Here,
comes down. There. And all we're looking for right now is just a basic, very basic shape. It's all we're concerned with. Really pushing that paint in there. Just midnight black, little Van Dyke brown in it. Okay, maybe this comes over and bloop, maybe there's a little
It's a little bit darker.
Now, when you do your painting, you do it any way that you want to do it. Maybe your mountain has a totally different shape, and that's fine. Painting should make you happy. If it does nothing else.
I'm miserable, Bob.
Make you happy. And if it doesn't make you happy, you're doing the wrong thing.
Oh, this is so nice. Fine. How's he getting white in his?
All of your life, it make you happy. Needless to say, you're going to be a happy person.
How's that happening?
There we are. Now then, I'll just take this old big brush, and very gently, I'll grab some of this and just pull it. This is just pulling the paint down. It removes excess paint, makes it even so you can add more colors on top of it. That's all. There we go. Just let it blend right on down toward the base. Okay. Well, we have one huge mountain today. Well, we said we was going to do a big mountain, so what the heck? That's all right. That's all right. Wash the old brush off.
What's with the mountain, Bob? Why it's so big?
There we are. There we are.
Oh, man. He, like, finished his mountain.
Now, let's take some white.
Hold on.
Dark sienna.
Go back. Hold on. I'm not done with my mountain yet. So he went all the way. Knife dry, knife texture. There's glaze. Glaze, maybe? Kind of bring some of that down. Yeah, he went all the way down to the water, kind of. Bring some of this color down. Then we'll blend it in. Just painting a happy little mountain. Just a happy little guy. Just a happy little mountain. Just like that. I thought there was a big green spot here, but it's just the dead pixels on my tablet. Try not to do things at random. He's always like, don't just do things at random. Have a purpose to what you're doing. Where's our blending? Textured blender. Just pull some of that down. Soften this stuff a little bit. And I think we're in a good spot from here. Yeah, usually that those dead pixels don't bother me, but for here, when you're trying to paint with color, it's definitely bothersome.
Let's have some fun now. Let's take some white.
Hey, Bratwurst Hoovy, it has been a while. How's your Butterfinger mount?
Just bought this new Lamborghini here. Fun to drive up here.
Forgot you have your own alert.
But you know what I like a lot more than materialistic
things?
Dark sand
on one side and white.
Knowledge.
White.
Knowledge.
Now, maybe over in here, we'll take some...
So he's getting like a...
Van Dyke brown, a little black. Add a little of the Prussian blue to it.
Oh, man, what is that color?
I'm making several different colors.
Oh.
More blue.
I think there is a mixing window.
So we want it. Oh, that's
mixing
nice.
Palette.
That's nice. That's what we're looking for. Leave all these colors marbled. Now, let me wipe the old knife off. I just wipe it on a paper towel. Now then, let's go up here, get our little roll of paint on the small knife, and let's begin picking out some of these little highlights. Touch, no pressure. No pressure at all. Touch and just pull.
Man, the way he does the palette knife stuff is always impressive.
Get back in there. No pressure, though. No pressure. Here and there, we can go back with a little dark. Add some little...
So there's some of our colors.
All kinds of beautiful little things that are happening.
He's grabbing his knife.
Let your imagination go and do whatever you want. Just all types of little things happening here, though. But absolutely no pressure with
no
the knife.
No pressure. No pressure.
If you put pressure, it's going to look like you iced a cake. And just
I'm trying to figure out how to hold it.
Pulling him down.
Because it keeps angling the way I don't want it to angle.
Here and there. Touch.
This way? Hmm.
And there's always some dark shadow areas in there.
Sure.
You can just drop them in, blend some colors in. Boy, you can just make some of the most ferocious mountains. This is where the old mountain goat lives. He hangs out up here and has a good time. Okay, maybe over in here even.
No pressure.
Some little things happening. All right. Now then, go right into some straight midnight black. Let's come right up here. Maybe there's a peak it lives right there. Goes maybe way up here. Comes down through there, wherever you want it. Just sort of think about all the things that live in this mountain.
I'm thinking about it, Bob.
Tell you what, maybe there's a glacier in there. Maybe there's some snow laying up there. I'm taking a little of the Prussian blue and white, mixing it together. Very little blue. Little roll of paint.
So
if you
fun.
Want to have a glacier, maybe, I'll tell you what, maybe he lives right along there.
Man, how?
Make a decision. Drop him in. Just let
crazy.
Him, just let him lay in there and sleep. There.
So amazing he could do that with just a palette knife.
I don't know. And you know, when you buy your first tube of paint, you get an artist's license. And that license says you can do anything that makes you happy. So use that license. It's yours forever and ever. Okay. Back to our black. Maybe now we'll just have all kinds of little things that live right along in here. Like so, wherever we want them. Maybe that comes there. We don't know. We don't know. Wherever. Shoot, maybe some of that snow's laying down in here. But it's just playing games here with contrast. A lot of nice contrast going on. Maybe there's a little snow. There it is.
There it is.
Just think.
It's a stillness.
These areas where there would be little areas that maybe the snow would fall in there and it didn't melt and beautiful things happen. Okay. And a little touch of bright red here in my color. Shoot, we get crazy. A little more of the dark sienna.
Let's get crazy.
But leave it marble so you have all these streaks happening. Because when you pick up that roll of paint, those streaks are still in the paint. They're still in
there.
Yeah,
some of this stuff you really...
Come along in here.
Digital's no substitute.
A little bit. Put a little highlight here and there. That little light play across.
Really can't get those little imperfections.
Little shadow here and little shadow there. There we go. Okay.
just all kinds of nice things happening.
It's more of the dark over here.
Hmm.
There. And begin applying some little shadow things. Gotta make those little noises. Make those little noises. Little the color in here, it plays right down through there. Just let your imagination go. You know, it's fantastic. I get so many letters from young people all across the country that are painting. And painting has opened whole new worlds to them. And it's so wonderful to hear from the from people. My gosh, some of them, 3, 4, 5 years old, their parents write and tell me that children have taken an interest in it, and they watch the show, and they paint. In some areas, I have friends that have started painting clubs, especially in high school and in college and et cetera. And they get together and they paint together. And they had some Bob Ross painting clubs, and I was absolutely flattered to hear that. Absolutely flattered.
Blend it out a little bit.
And they've sent me some photographs, a little roll of paint, of some of the things that they're painting. It's unreal. It's unreal. And young people have a better imagination than I do. Boy, they can paint some of the most beautiful things. Here, we're just putting in little doers wherever you want them. Maybe there's another stone here in the front.
A little bit of shadow over here.
Maybe up here. Just sort of look around and see where you think a stone should live in your world. These are some rough mountains. And if you take your time, you can do some unbelievable effects like this. Just take your time and work at it and play. Enjoy.
Yeah, there's some effects you get from this program that I don't really know how you would do in Clip Studio.
Or to enjoy what you do in life.
Like these palette knives and stuff.
Then you'll do a good job.
Pretty cool.
And I certainly enjoy what I'm doing. I spend half my life doing somebody else's thing. And if you can ever get a job doing the thing that you like to do best, then it's wonderful. I'm just taking a clean, dry 2-inch brush and just tapping. Just tapping. I want to create a little mist down here at the base of this little mountain, big mountain.
How is that? Maybe with a
there.
Soft, noisy
stuff. Then lift gently upward. That takes out the tap marks, brings it all together.
Like this? This is how you do tapping?
Over here, you'll follow these angles. Sometimes it's nice just to take the brush the same way.
It'd be really fun to paint with actual oil paints. They seem very forgiving in a lot of ways, as far as like blending with them and stuff.
We can even do a little touch of it here. You can take a little green, a yellow ochre or something. It doesn't matter. Tap a little color in there. I just want to show you how. I don't really...
Green and yellow.
We're not really going to do much of it, but you can see. Just follow the angles and go right on up. And you can have grass growing all down here at the foot of your mountain. And that's very pretty and very effective. Okay. That's enough of that. I'll wash the old brush. Just to show you how to do that. There we are. Maybe back here. Let's have some fun. Mm-hmm. Shoot. We take some black, Prussian blue, Van Dyke brown. There's some crimson, maybe a little sap green, whatever you got. Just mix it up, as long as it's dark. Okay, let me wipe my knife off here. We just wipe this knife on old paper towel. Okay, find a fan brush. Maybe back here in the back.
Band brush time.
Maybe there's some little trees live back here. Let's drop some of those in.
Where's my fan brush?
And this is one of the easiest ways to make the indication of a lot of little trees far away. Just take the brush and tap downward.
So under here?
That's all there is to it.
Fan brush, here
you
we
can
go.
You make a whole forest in a second here. There we go. And we're just looking for basic, very basic shapes. These are too far away to have much detail. Now, sometimes, here's a problem that happens. You'll make them like this, and it
Oh, that's too much water. See how it like bleeds like that?
If that should happen, all you do is just add a few more trees.
It's kind of cool, but that's not what we want.
They get too far apart. Dry. They look like a fence. And you can either add a few more trees or put wire on it. Either way. Whatever. If you want a fence, then that's what you ought to have. Sometimes maybe you want one there.
His fan brush is a lot sharper.
Show that last
maybe
show
this
that
isn't the right brush to use.
So it had Hank Snow in it. That son of a gun's a heck of a painter. I really enjoyed my time with him. We went to Nashville, Annette and I did.
No.
Painted with Hank and a couple other people from the Grand Ole Opry a couple of days. He's a lovely, lovely man. Hope he sings on the Grand Ole Opry for another 50 years.
Fan brush, you can't quite do the same effect that he's doing. We'll try it out.
I want to create the illusion down here. Maybe some little trunks on those trees. So I'll just take a little white on the fan brush. Grab it, lift upward. Make it look like little trunks that are far, far away. If you happen to put one in there that's too light, just rub it a little bit. It'll go away. Okay.
And some white.
Maybe back here. Just use that same old color. Just gonna tap in what'll end up being a little land area back there. Little land. See, remember we wasn't worried about where our lake was gonna be or a little pond. Because we decided we could just chop off whatever we didn't want. Now's the time to do that. Decide where your pond's gonna be, grab, pull straight down. Just pull it straight down. And this will be the reflection. Instant reflections, that easy. Then go gently and lightly across. There you are. Okay, now then, let's put some pretty things out there. Maybe this is fall, and all the beautiful colors are beginning to happen. Shoot, let's get over here in some red and Indian yellow. Make this one with a lot of red in it. But when you do it, you make it with any color that you want. I'm just in a mood today to do some beautiful colors. Some nice, bright colors. It's a fantastic day. It's a good day to be alive. Come to think of it, every day's a good day to be alive. There we are. Just tap him. Okay. Maybe we'll come over on this side. Just drop in a few more little things. Now think about the lay of the land. It begins getting very important. Ooh, beautiful red color there. In Alaska, we have a lot of mountains like this, and in the fall, the colors will change, and you have all the oranges and yellows and red. Looks like a painter went crazy.
Hey, Kyla, how's it going?
All over the landscape. I've never seen such things as Alaska has in the autumn. The colors are absolutely spectacular. A little bit here and there. Okay. Now then, let's take a little bit of Van Dyke Brown. Let's just scrub a little dirt down here at the bottom. Just really scrubbing that in. There we go. A little bit of the liquid white on the knife. And with that,
it's too saturated. Need to stay away from the saturation here.
Just to break it up. There we go.
Easy to do when you're painting digital.
All right. Tell you what, let's do. Maybe back here, maybe there's some bigger evergreens. We'll just take the fan brush, go right into that color. A lot of paint in the bristles. Let's go right up here. Maybe there lives in our world. Maybe there's an evergreen lives there. Just sort of look around in your painting, because each painting is different. Each painting is different. Just put them in and go with them, wherever you want them. Wherever. Let's put one on the other side. What the heck? Right there. There he is. There he is.
There he is.
Now then. Maybe down in here there's some Tell you what, let's do. Let's put some, yep, right along here. Let's just close this little pond in. If we had another 10 minutes on the show, there wouldn't be a pond at all. We just keep taking a little more and a little more away from it.
Boy, he's so fast.
There.
Trying to catch up.
But now you have just a skinny little pond out there. Just enough to be very pretty. Okay, we can come back with our nice highlight colors, our fall colors, the ochres and yellows and bright red.
I'm not sure how to do his fan brush thing all kinds of
little,
on here.
Little grassy things here. Oh, there's more of that red. I like that. It's pretty.
It kind of faces the wrong way. It's not quite working.
There we go. Just decide where you want them. Drop them in. That's all. Maybe. Tell you what, let's have a little bit of fun. Maybe down here in the foreground, take some liquid white.
Go some into titanium
some, we'll use some cad yellow. Right over here and grab a little of the bright red. Whew. Make a firecracker here. Let's go right up here. Maybe there lives a happy little bush right along here. A little more of the red. Just put all kinds of little, look at that. Little bush right here in front. Maybe, ooh, there's a nice red one. Jack Frost has hit him hard. Really thumped him. There we go.
It's good for bushes, but it's hard to do like in trees with this brush.
And in our world, maybe there lives a nice evergreen tree right there. Use just the corner of the fan brush. Work back and forth, back and forth. There we are. Right down there. Shoot, that's fun. Let's have one over here. There he goes.
There he is.
There, back and forth. Had a lady in class one time, she called these Z-trees, like Zorro. That might be an excellent analogy, just back and forth. Back and forth. I get a lot of letters asking if I still teach classes. And I really don't teach many classes anymore. We have a lot of young people that are good and tough. They can go out here and do it. I got lazy, I want to stay at home. Little trunk here, a little brown and white. But we have...
Oh no, my paint's dripping.
Travel around and teach.
That's fine.
Including my son Steve, that little rascal. Well, he's a heck of a painter. A little yellow, a little green. Put a little highlight on these trees and I think we'll be about done. Come right along there. A little more sap green. That's a little too bright yet. Oh, that's nicer. Yeah, I call Steve a little devil. He's 6'5". He's not so little. He calls me Shorty.
I don't like that.
Little highlight on these little trees. Shoot, we got to finish painting.
Yeah, it'd be nice if the
this one. It's a lot of fun.
Fan brush behaved more like a fan brush.
Challenge.
That's probably hard to recreate.
And to make some fantastic effects. So, until next time, from all of us here, happy painting and God bless.
That was fun. How'd your guys' paintings turn out? Need to sign it now. Go away, Bob. I'm gonna sign my painting. Hey, Gary the Snail. Good to see you again. Vibes today are the opposite today. Yeah, it all depends, right? The vibe of every stream is going to be different. Man, this paint is really running. It's not really what I wanted it to do. Maybe I can dry this off. Keep it from doing that. There is a way to dry off the whole layer, but I'm not sure how you do it. Is there a way to smudge this back up? Nah, it doesn't quite work. That was an experience. All right, let's sign this piece of garbo. Jesse. Yay. That was fun. So yeah, I don't know how I feel about this software. I don't know if I'm gonna get it, but it's very fun to mess around with. Maybe I'll keep playing with it. Keep drawing on it, but at this point I think I like Clip Studio Paint better. And if I want to do painting, I'll just do actual painting. I think that's my feeling on it. But yeah, thanks for tuning in, guys. Thanks for hanging out with me. Hope y'all have a good rest of your day. I'll catch y'all next time, and yeah, happy painting. I'll see y'all later. Bye-bye. Let's see what we could pass the love on to. Who could we raid? Yeah, that was fun. I really liked messing around with that program. I have it for 30 days, so, you know, I'll keep trying it. We haven't raided Gadworks before. If you don't follow Gadworks, he's a really good cartoonist animator. Definitely worth following if you don't know them already. Alright guys, I'll see y'all over there. Take it easy, have a good one. I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye!